Hello. Welcome. Good day. It's good to be here. Let's jump right into it. Today I'm just going to kind of chill. Hey, thanks, Gonzo. I'm glad you're here. Good day to you, sir. And thank you for the sound check. We'll go ahead and start the day off with 2 out of 7 things done. And yeah, just going to kind of quietly play the whole Tamriel Rebuilt soundtrack kind of for until however long it goes. I think like an hour or so. Just while we're getting started today, it's like really fantastic music. Check out the Bandcamp if you can. We'll pull it up right here. And start off. You're unable to hear music. Oh, okay. Yeah, it must just be really quiet. Hold up. Should hear something now. Give it a little more kick. Yeah, gotta go ahead and give this a purchase here on Bandcamp. Actually like purchasing music here because they have a lot of really good DRM-free options. For the time being, at least. Ooh, Skywind. I bet you that's cool. Still not hearing anything. Oh no, okay. Hold on. This is almost certainly... Yeah, okay, it's still really, really quiet. Let me kick up the gain. You can hear the music. Hey, it's Catastrophe. I'm glad you're here, man. I hope you're doing good today. Just light. Okay, let me turn the gain up a little bit. Bring it more into the green. Happy Sunday fun day, my friend. I'm so glad you're here. How's it going, everyone? Indeed. Oh, Hudrax, hey, good day to you. I'm glad you're here. All right. I'm doing really well today. It's a 2 pots of coffee kind of a day for me, but other than that, hoping to start off with some cool stuff here today, actually. You may recall we left off spending most of the day yesterday kind of rethinking the landing page. You may recall, Gonzo, you may recall some nasty stats regarding 90 database queries. What's going on with my notes here? Hold up. There we go. Oh my. Let's just kill that. Dupe day. Woof. You may recall some nastiness with 90 database queries just to get, you know, 3 numbers. Let's start right there, actually, because I got up a little bit. Hey, Santa, my man, I'm glad you're here. Thank you for being here. Have a good day today. Hacking on the website. So yeah, anyway, as I was just saying, if you weren't here yesterday or you don't recall, we had a cool idea here. Gonzo had the idea. Throw the count of mods on here. Which I began to do, actually, and it actually worked out pretty well. Here, we just want to maybe remove the turning it black when I highlight it. And we'll want to check what it looks like with light mode. But yeah, I mean, just to get, you know, just this count of these mods is like, you know, 90 queries. And if you click on the nice little handy thing we have here, isn't available anymore. Okay, it wants me to refresh the page, probably. Let's try it again. Boom. We see, you know, there's a lot of duplication going on here. 82 similar queries. Yikes. So actually, this morning, just doing a little bit of hacking on the problem, and I found one weird trick. Check this out. And so what I'm doing here is, there's a few things going on here. But, you know, of note is this thing right here. Mod list, top level lists. And that's what's called a query manager. And that basically is a predefined database query that I programmed with some Python ahead of time. We can look at that in the diff in a bit. But that's what's of note here. So I have a distilled query. Zoom in just a bit. Of all the top level lists, and by that I mean, you know, iHeart Vanilla, which is just a really short standalone, or like Expanded Vanilla, which is a bunch of groupings of smaller lists. Expanded Vanilla would be the top level list, right? So I have one query here that I'm putting into the mod lists variable. And then I'm using that to further extract, give me total overhaul, give me expanded vanilla, and so on. And I'm passing that into the page now. And something interesting happens when I do this. Okay, fine. We're putting the comma there then. Something interesting happens when I do this, though. We go from 90 queries Oh my god. Well, it stays at 90 queries. I swear earlier it dropped down significantly when I was getting ready for the stream. Okay, well, at the very least, we don't increase the count of queries by doing that. And we have a little bit less repetition here. So, well, okay, well. So we still have the duplicates here. Yeah, well, okay, well, never mind. I thought I had something cool. Womp. In any case, though, the whole reason why I went down this path, though, is because we have an awkward kind of floating button right here. Like, these ones have a nice little show of numbers, and then this one's kind of awkwardly hanging down there. And we could, like, use a little CSS to bump it up, or we could put some numbers down there, right? Maybe show how many mod lists we have. So we could do something like this. Make sure we're getting that context in here. Let's do this. I'm not 100% sure that that's what I need. Just gonna roll with it. I think it looks pretty okay. Just the main thing here is, you know, we want to not have, because this is a little bit jarring here, right? Like when I mouse over it. Let's real quick take a look at what it looks like in light mode. Whew. You can't even see the awkward. Okay, so indeed. Gonzo says, haha. Yeah, yeah. Well, so glad you tested that, Gonzo says. So actually, it turns out I have broken, because I always use dark mode, I have broken light mode for months at a time before and not known it. Until one day I was just like, thought to test it, you know, and it was just utterly garbage and thought, oh dear God, somebody has been looking at this for months. So anyways, let's fix that. And so I stuffed all the CSS for the site that I wrote, hacked on top of. So I use something called skeleton.css. It's what kind of gives the overall look here, is 99% skeleton. I slapped dark mode on top of that. I don't know, maybe a modern version of skeleton has dark mode, but this one's from like 2016. Never updated it. So I slapped dark mode in there. Anywho, though, let's do what we got to do here. We want to give these guys here. Yeah, awesome. Hudrax Kustos. Morrowind on the main screen. Johnny's stream on the right. Just hanging with fellow OpenMW enthusiasts. That's a cool Sunday vibe. That's right. That's right indeed. So what we want to do here is give these divs here a specific class. And I'm going to say, you know, don't do specific colorings at specific times. So anyway, let's just do that real quick. Class, and this is going to be, count. Button count, because that's what it is. It's a count, goes along with the button. It is actually encompassed, so it's not actually a button. If you look closely here, a little bit of hackery here, but these are not actually, there is an actual HTML button element. We're not using it here. Instead, we're using a class that kind of dresses it up like a button. Because it is a link. So, you know, we could use the button element, which by default, I think, gives you the button look, not the button primary look, which button primary gives you the black. And the just button class gives you, I believe, the kind of white button with a black outline. So anyway, it's a part of the link here. So, and we're gonna do just this one and see how we did. So let's say we have it. And I'm not exactly an arch magister of CSS, so bear with me. I've hacked enough to kind of make things work, though. Let's see here. So we got button count. It's going to be a div. Div. If you can, with CSS, be specific. It's usually good, you know. And so we do have an A that's holding a div called button count. And that's sort of how we express that over here. Okay. And then so we'll say, So let's try and key in on the hover of the A, since that's the outer element. This is where I'm not really sure, like, the implementations of CSS. Who drags? No worries there, Johnny. You can use divs and spans and still make your page more semantic than most of what's out there on the web. Yeah. That's a good call out, and I'm not, like, you know, casting shade on any other web authors there, but it's like, sometimes, you know, you just don't know about best practices, or you don't have time or funding or whatever to do it, you know, or sometimes you just don't care, and that's the case a lot of the time, you know. And a goal that I have with this website that I talked about yesterday, just always have had, is to keep the page small, no JavaScript requirement, you know, for the basic functions, that kind of a thing. Just be thoughtful, you know, like somebody might be on a potato internet connection that's like dial-up equivalent, you know. And it's frustrating, you know, to have stuff load. So anyways, and it appears that a lot of viewers to the website, if we may just take a look, a lot of viewers to the website actually view many, many pages, which is, I think, a unique characteristic among websites. You have a lot of people that are coming to the website and not viewing just one or two pages, but they're viewing like a lot, you know, because we have 35. This is just so this, to be clear, where these numbers come from is anybody who is not blocking JavaScript and who is not blocking my stats.modding OpenMW domain. So, and has a modernish, you know, like if you have IE9, I don't know if that's like a web browser from 10 years ago. I don't know if it's going to work. So anyway, there is a chunk, maybe a small chunk of visitors. This isn't counting. But you have 35K-ish unique visitors looking at 41K pages, you know. So that's like a handful or more, a lot more, you know, per visit, which I think is pretty cool. All right, so we have the hover. We're putting the hover hack on here, and we want to say, what do we want the color to be? It's not just straight black, I don't think. So this is how we're going to find out. No. Shrink that down a little bit. So this thing, when you're developing a website, if you didn't know, maybe some of my fellow web developers out there already know about the developer tools. Chrome has a similar one, and anything that's based on Chrome, like Microsoft Edge, you know, probably has something similar to this. But yeah, you just click this little button here, and it's like, boom, anything you want to know. Tell me what you want to know. I want to know what is... It is just straight up black. Okay, cool. All right. So we're going to say color... I don't like to use just the... I like to be specific, right? And put the code or whatever in there. All right, well, let's just really quick... Okay, no. On the hover here was wrong. Yeah, because it's already black when we hover. This is where I have to sanity check myself with a fresh browser, because caching is like, oh no. Caching is a real thing. And I don't use Chrome normally. Okay, no, I done goofed. My code is wrong. Let's fix it. All right. Which one did I do here? Oh, yeah. It should be all lists here. So let's key in on that one there. You can see that right here. Did I do something stupid like not save? No, I saved it. Okay. Yeah, there's no color at all showing up here. What if we just, there we go. It's the nice thing about modern DevTools things here is you can just... Let's put a color in there without actually putting it in there. And then it's cool to see, like, okay, whoop! I was just gonna say, it's cool to see, does it do what I want? Right away, cross it out. Okay. So what in the hierarchy? Tell you what, let's get extreme here. Let's just put it in line. Just for the sake of seeing it work, if that even works. Yeah, there we go. Okay, good. Obviously, we don't want to do that because it will be difficult to express how it should look with, you know, with dark mode as well this way. We need to be able to put it in the CSS file. Okay. You know, so I thought that's literally what I put here. Div class button count. All right, so maybe this is wrong here, and I'm trying to be clever here. Hudrak says, will we be able to access the whole web page source code's history on GitLab, or just the last version? I ask because, at least for me, it can be a great asset to study web development. That's a great question. Thank you. Thank you so much for asking that. And the answer is, every commit I ever did on the website, including commits going back to before I ever imagined anybody would be looking at the source code. So keep that in mind if you look at anything and see, like, dear God, what was he thinking? But everything's in there. The good, the bad, the ugly, the really, really got dang ugly. Oh, come on, GitLab. Just give me a page so I can go to the... Anyways, it's all there. Everything. You can go back to the very beginning. And actually, I was thinking about doing this sometime, like looking at the first... like functional version of the website and kind of like what did it look like, you know, way back, like talking circa 2016 or so. Actually, here, we can do this. Not rely on GitLab's trash UI. Let's just go to the very end here. Initial commit. Thursday, November 9, 2017, even. But the domain goes back to 2016 because I didn't, the very first iteration of this website was not written with, so this is a Django Python web application. And the very first iteration of this website was not written quite that way. It was a bunch of just static HTML files. And it kind of grew from there because I wanted to learn to, you know, work with Django a little bit more. So yeah, that's a great question. Thank you for bringing that up. All right. So yeah, just erase this other class. There was, you know, E for effort, I guess, to try and, oh, you know what, let's take my inline color out here. Give me false hope that I have succeeded. Boom. There you go. So, I was being a little too, I was just trying to be a little too fancy there. No need. And let's put that on all of these. And then let's look at it again in dark mode, you know, just to be sure we're good to go. But I think we will be good to go. There's no need to fear CSS, but oh boy, it's tricky. And, you know, I thought I was being clever, like, it's a, you know, it's a div in an A. Come on, you know, that's a totally correct query, but no, apparently it wasn't. This is just as good. You know, this is functionally just as good. I don't think we need to worry too much about, whoops. Don't try that at home. Wow. I don't think we need to worry about being perfect or what might be considered perfect. Ooh. Is this more caching here, though? Whoa. Uh-huh. Yeah, okay. It's cached. You can see there. We don't have the required style attached. Disable cache is checked, but that's a big lie. Maybe only for the purposes of the network tab. No, that's a big fat lie. Because we can prove this. If I open my... Hoop! Fat-fingered. Don't try this at home again. Yeah, there we go. We know it's working now, because there it is. Well, of course, it looks hideous in dark mode, though, which we're going to have to fix. Oh! What happened? That's no good. First off, did I do it right? Oh, yeah. No, I didn't at all. The astute observers out there, you probably noticed. I made a goof and put the class on the wrong thing. Whew. There we go. I should have known something was wrong when those buttons were black. Whoops. And there we go. So, okay, great. Light mode, looking good. And props to Gonzo. This was a fantastic idea. I think it makes the... And you can look... I think it's okay that you can click the 22 mods part that's below the... I think that's okay. Maybe we want to make that a button too. I think it really looks great. You could argue it's a little janky that you can click outside the button to click the button. I don't know. I think it's fine. Anyways, let's fix dark mode and then we can worry about that. Because dark mode clearly is borked now. So, how dark mode works on the website, if you're not familiar with web design and stuff, is the easiest way to support it without really trying is to do something like this in your head, in your header. And you have just a link like this, a link element, which is how you refer to external style sheets, for example. And you do what's called a media query, this one right here. And you just say, prefers color scheme dark. And that means that when the web browser, through various machinations determined by your operating system, knows that you prefer dark, load that style sheet. Not really much logic I have to do on my end. It's pretty great. There is some logic we do on this website because we allow people to decide if they want light or dark. Which I've debated removing that feature just because I feel like if you want dark, you tell your OS you want dark and so forth. But anyway, without going too deep down that rabbit hole, let's fix the dark mode. So I've got, as you saw, I have a site-dark.css, which is just a tiny file of the various changes that are needed to make dark mode decent. Excuse me here. Gotta re-up on the coffee. All right. And so we want to say here, button count. And so, what then is the white color that we see here? Is it just white? I don't know. We should not guess, because if we're wrong, it'll look terrible. And we may not know it, but somebody will. Yeah, it's not. It's E4. It's good color. So let's throw it in there. Oh my goodness. E4. Oop. I'm all fat fingers today. Wowee. Okay. But, oh wait, cool. No. I was going to say it might do hideous things on a hover, but it doesn't. Kind of just looks okay. It does bug me a little bit. You know, that you can click here. You know, I kind of like want to have almost a fat button. Like a hamburger button, you know, taller one. But I don't know. I think this is fine. We're going to roll with it for now. All right. So, with that, let's do a real quick sanity check here. Dark mode looks pretty good. Let's take a look at what it looks like on a mobile. Firefox dev mode having this really neat thing you can click over here to approximate. And you can give it dimensions, you know, for what kind of mobile you want here. 320 by 480 is like a... It's like a 20-year-old smartphone. Not 20-year-old, but yeah, 10-year-old smartphone. Very small one. A modern device would be a bit bigger than this, but anyway, let's shoot low. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I think this works, honestly. And like on a mobile device in particular, one with a screen this small, you know, it might help for people with fat fingers to kind of, you know. So I'm shipping this. If you hate it, Gonzo, you can say in the MR. All right. So I guess the last thing I want to do, I actually love what we have here. I really do. I think we've done a... Yeah, I love it. Awesome. Thank you, Gonzo. Because I love it too. I personally believe that we have achieved the goal of simplifying the front page, but also making it more useful for somebody who's like new here today. You know, if you don't know where to go, you can just click this button that says start here, and it's truthful. Which brings us to the next thing that we got to do, though. We left off yesterday just kind of throwing some stuff in here, being a little horrified at the query count that getting this information cost us. But as I talked to Gonzo off stream afterwards, turns out that this actually loads. It loads fine. It's not really, you know, boom. So, like, yeah, 325 queries. It's a little horrifying, but on the other hand, like, you know, we have a, let's open our friendly dev console here. Let's open up that network tab, and we can see that this page loaded in 726 milliseconds. Just over a second total, which I think is pretty good, considering I got the potatoest of potato servers here. You know, one CPU, no resources. It's actually quite fun to see how far we can stretch this website code with such a weak machine and keep it really performant, you know, and here we go. Still works. All right, yeah, look, so I was looking up in the excellent, very, very excellent Django documentation how to do some database query tricks. All right, so going back to here, we got what we want to do here is, I think, please refresh my memory, Gonzo, if you recall. Yesterday, we wanted to put, so it says choose a mod list, and I was thinking maybe we can just have, how about this? Okay. All right, so actually, let's take a step back, because one thing that we can do here is we can use my... Gonzo says, I remember you saying you wanted a send-off, so I thought you were going to relocate that down to the bottom of the page. Yes, the send-off, what to do next on the... Yeah, we'll get... Yes, that is one of the things, and we'll get there. So, you may recall from yesterday, I had this little thing here, where I was trying to get only the mod lists that are, you know, the big ones, and not the child sublists. And so I did this, you know, kind of thing, which is fine. But now it's no longer needed because the list of lists that I'm giving the page is already filtered such, you know. So I can actually just go like this and I'm only going to get the ones that I want. And we can confirm that by reloading the page right now. And I'm going to take a sip of coffee. Damn you. There we go. Same information. Just one less block. Less is more. So, all right. Down at the bottom, huh? Okay. So I had a what's next section that I wanted to do. Let's see here. Okay. And so the whole point of what's next, I was thinking. Let me know what you folks think. Was that okay? You know about how to get set up. You know about tips, performance. You know about mod lists. You know about how to verify, roughly speaking. You know about how to find upcoming changes. Maybe we should mention the stream right here. Mm-hmm. Put it in there for sure. Just want to keep going with my flow here. You know about all this stuff, so what do you have to know about next? And, you know, I think that's really what I want to convey here, if there's something to convey, though. Yeah. And I'm just, right now, I'm kind of struggling, so let's take a step back. Let's go to the copy of the website that will load faster. So one thing, unfortunately, that I've done is I've hidden quite a few pages. Let's try to find some of them, for example. The whole, for example, getting started. All of these now are completely hidden. So maybe what we should do here maybe like a heading right here that's a link. And it says the first things required to get going are buy a copy of Morrowind and install OpenMW. And those bypass this page to go to these pages respectively. Actually, this whole page exists to bypass this page, which is arguably not really useful on its own. But I still feel like we should link to it somehow. At the bottom, maybe, so we don't, you know, make it easy to miss the information that is actually good. Okay. Don't remember the name of this URL, so let's see. Getting started was getting started. Thank you, past me, kind of. We have the whole underscore versus dash thing here. Hudrak says, one thing on what's next could be encouraging people to join the modding OpenMW in the OpenMW Discord channel. If we funnel all the site's conversations there, can be useful in the long term. I agree. That's a great idea. And that's more or less what I was thinking, right? With the whole mention the stream here. Let's see. So what do we say? Whoops. So I do have a mention of the Discord right here. Under report a problem or ask a question. But maybe we can, like, mention it again. Just mention it again right here, you know, hey. By the way, we also, as we mentioned above, we've got the IRC Discord channel, you know. It's worth mentioning it again, for sure. I'll put it right here. Also mention Discord. See again. Cool, very good call out. Thank you. Thank you for that. All right, so what's next? Yeah, no, you're good. My bad, didn't see it mentioned above. You're all good. That's the whole, right? Like, if you didn't see it there, the question is then who else is going to kind of miss it there? Because it's like, you know, third in a bullet list of four things, you know? So it's missable, frankly. All right. Yeah, I kind of lost my turn. Okay, yeah. So I was putting a link up here for the setup steps index. Getting started index, rather. And I like this page because it's got all these other buttons on here. You know, like suddenly we have unvanished all these buttons. We've, you know, prevented them from kind of getting completely lost. So that's good. I'm happy with this. If this isn't like too hideous of a thing to kind of just chuck down there. And similarly, the tips page is now basically this tips page, because we have the getting started tips and then the tips page. But this is similarly lost now because I'm bypassing it. So let's go down here. Oh, yeah, cool. This is the song that Atualpa and I used in the 0.47 release video, which if you haven't seen it, give it a watch. Yep, there we go. Just got a sanity check. Open, never mind. Yeah. Oh, man, that was so fun. I just remember back to how that idea was born, sort of. And it was just, it was totally awesome. It came together so quick, you know, just Atualpa and I, like, whipped together the video in, like, no time. Look at this. I'm using a dash here, underscore up there. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, Open Nevermind was so fun to do. I loved that. And the reception was great because some people, like, weren't sure if we were serious or not, you know, because it was actually playable and still is. What did I call it? I got caught up. I don't want that tips. I want that tips, which I just call tips. Cool. Gonzo says 0.13.37 also. Yeah, so that was Peter McKeeve's idea for the version, and he stressed when we did this. Maybe you've seen this. I've got on my on the GitLab org. I actually have a rehost with his permission, of course. Wow, it's on page 2. We have so much junk here. Open Nevermind has its own repo and its own website. And Peter McKeeve himself asked specifically that if we ever push a new version, that it always has to be just always 0.13.37. Like, I will just repush. If we make a change, we're just going to repush that tag, and that's always the version. And I'm fine with that. It's totally a violation of everything I do professionally, but we don't, you know, you just got to have fun. Hudrak says, since I joined that Discord channel, for me, it became so much more than a place to ask questions or solve issues. It's more of a hangout spot. Lots of interesting conversations going on there. Maybe emphasize that aspect below. Could be cool. Hey, that's a great call out. Thank you for saying that, Hudrix. That's absolutely the, you know, the thing I'm going for. That's what drew me to OpenMW all those years ago in the IRC channel. Just a bunch of people hanging out, being people that like Morrowind more than you reasonably should. You know, and that's what we're all here for. So yeah, very good. Keep that in mind, and when we're going down there to type that, keep that in mind. We're gonna get there in a minute. We're going from the top down here. Because that is a good thing to stress, right? Set people up for, hey, you know, that's where you, Space Farmer, my man, hey, I'm glad you're here today. It's good to see you again. Link to OpenMW Discord. In fact, we do have that on there, but we're going to put it again because it's, we talked about with Hudrax. It's a little bit easy to miss here. We got 4 points and it's like number 3 there, kind of buried. Finally home on the weekend. Okay, right on, my man. Cool. Well, I hope you're doing good today. We got to get some mind testing again soon, probably. Okay, so what did I just do? Visit the tips index here. Yeah. Because that's a page I felt got buried, kind of, here. And I think as long as we're exposing this again, the curious explorer of the website can find these pages. And we can, you know, I don't want to clutter this page too much, so we can think in the future anything else we need to plug in here. But for now, I think it's pretty good, so what's next, right? All right, well, taking a step back, I wonder, you know, we had the list of mod lists and the rough mod counts. I think Gonzo said he wanted the descriptions. Does that really fit on this page? If so, where? I thought maybe we could have it here on the choose a mod list section, but I mean, maybe that's venturing close to, you know, cluttering the page too much. This is also a bit of a bare section, though. You agree with that, putting it up here under choose a mod list? Okay. Well, let's just, before we get down here, I know I'm hungry to do this section too, but let's fill this in a bit. Let's just see, try it on and see what it looks like. Okay, mod list. Oop. Fat finger sauce today. Oh my goodness. All right. Oh, wow, we're not even halfway through the TR tunes, by the way. That's pretty cool. It's going to last probably the whole stream. Not bad. All right. Okay, so I feel like just awkwardly stuffing this here is... Maybe we need a small sentence here that says below is a list of the main mod lists and their descriptions. It feels weird to say list of the lists, but maybe it's fine. Just like reading that in my head over and over again, thinking, is that weird? I think that's weird. All right, list name. Just going from memory here, and I want to do, I love my bold. I don't know why. I have a thing. I like bold. Huh? That loaded way too fast. Okay. So we have a few things that happened here before I fix it. We got some raw HTML here. Oh, me oh my. And we have no title here. No name. This name here is nothing. I remembered incorrectly. Mod lists don't have names. They have titles. It is a title. And we have also a short... description, and you have to, as a safety feature built into Django's templating system, it's not automatically gonna render text that you give it as a safety feature, because you cannot trust text input from users. You have to tell it it's safe. Give me the HTML. Just give me the HTML. I'm not gonna hack myself. Give me the HTML as rendered text. And there we go. It looks how we wanted it. But wait, there's a problem. This isn't really a current mod list. We did have some enthusiastic user come into Discord, as I mentioned yesterday, wanting to, you know, up the presence of TES3MP, and I'm all about it. Multiplayer Morrowind, who's down? I'm down. You can do some insanely cool stuff, multiplayer Morrowind, that doesn't make sense at all, single player, but like it's natural multiplayer, and it's just, I noticed a typo here. it's actually a lot of fun. I'm not a multiplayer guy, usually. You know, I'm very like minimally multiplayer. I played multiplayer a bunch with Space Farmer. We did a bunch of Valheim. That was actually a lot of fun. You know, and way back in the day when I worked with Lord Exhale, I don't know if he's here today, but we played TF2 every day when we all worked at High Voltage Software together. You know, so I do like multiplayer, but and Minecraft, I've done a ton of Minecraft multiplayer and stuff, but Morrowind multiplayer is just different in an amazing way. Gonzo says, I really hope that guy pulls through. TES3MP plus MOMW would be great. Yeah, I used to have a website server and we had it, like, the chat was piped into my IRC channel, which I'm sure that there's, like, a Discord. I would hope there's a Discord bot. Now, it's one of the nice things about TES3MP Lua is it's not sandboxed the way OpenMW Lua is, so you can do a lot of naughty things that turn out to be fun. By naughty, I mean, like, file system access, you know, and things that are insecure. Space Farmer says, sea serpent hunting. If you never played Valheim, that was some of the most fun I had in that game, was just going out, like... basically naked on a boat and just getting wrecked by a serpent. I wasn't even mad. It was too fun. All right. Focus here. Focus, focus. I fixed the typo. BSA was a little A I noticed while I was talking. Okay, but yeah, so anyway, we want to weed that out. How do we do that? So as I mentioned before, and I said we were going to look at it in the diff, let's look at it right now. This is the query manager I mentioned before. That's the top level lists thing. And this is how you express that in Python with Django. You can call the class whatever the hell you want. The convention is to call it like something manager, because in Python there aren't really types that you can infer the type from, so it's useful to call it a manager. In Go, it's not considered idiomatic, for example, to call a type the type in the name, you know. We do it in Python. And then you have to implement the get query set method. Make sure you call super to do whatever the parent class does. And yeah, we say parent list none, but we need something else here to drill it down. And real quick, looks like Hudrex got a tangent here. On a quick tangent regarding mod lists, I have to give props to the site. Thank you. God, I appreciate that. The tips page and the rest of the site's help material gave such independence to my modding workflow that mod lists became more of a guideline than anything. From there, I'm being able to curate and adapt the mod lists to my taste, add new mods, etc. Wow. That's great feedback, Hudrex. Thank you for saying that, and I'm so glad that you found everything useful, and that is exactly the intention I had. Once I realized, you know, that people were using the website that weren't me, that's kind of the intention that I had, right? Like, I wanted to teach people to fish, so to say, rather than give them the fish, you know? Like, a lot of people... All right, Gonzo, gonna be right back. We'll be here. I wanted to, but yeah, rather than, like, because you get a lot of... It's kind of amazing how many questions I get about, like, can I get a zip file with everything all in one? And obviously, that would be great. For various reasons I'm not going to go into, we can't have that. So, absent that, you know, the next best thing is, like, to empower people to sort of, like, build their own, you know, castle in the sand. So, thank you. That's really great feedback. I love that, Hudrex. Thank you. And that's what I want, you know, people to get out of this project. You know, if I can leave... the Morrowind community with one thing, that would be really great to do. Okay, so we were doing this right here. We were showing each mod list and their description, but we had the beef about having the inactive list. And I wanted to check, do we have something that says a mod list is inactive? No, we don't really. So there's two ways we can approach this. And I'm going to go with the nasty, ugly way, unfortunately. And that is, I'm going to say... in the HTML, where are you? Right here. I'm going to say, if list title is not, yeah, you probably know what I'm about to do here. Oh no. Yeah, that's right. I'm basically just gonna hard code it in there. Womp, womp. If it's not that one, print it. And there we go. It's no longer in the list. Now, what would the right way to do it be? If I was going to spend more time doing this, we might say, sort of like how we have on mods, we might add an is active field here that is a Boolean field. And if you're not aware, a Boolean is what we call like a true, false, you know, zero for no, one for yes kind of a thing. And we might do that. The only reason I don't do it right now is because, as I've mentioned previously in previous streams, is we're getting to kind of the point in the website where the database is reaching a certain complexity. We have mods, we have mod lists, we have listed mods, we have sublists, we have a crazy kind of relationship that maybe a real database administrator might look at and be like, what are you on? But it's working for the website made by me, who doesn't really know too much about databases. I know a bit, enough to be dangerous, obviously. So anyway, the reason why I don't add it right now is just I'm a little nervous. What's the harm? Add a little field here, and then next thing you know, like, the page load time on every page is suffering or something like that. You know, we want to be really careful about that. And until I can thoughtfully measure performance, we're going to hold off on such changes. Because I've done things before that have really tanked performance, and that's why you need, for example, you need to do things like, if we could just take a look here at mod list detail here. Yeah. We've got some database query magic here with this select related bit here. And you can see my note here. This is an expensive set of queries. And select related is kind of a thing you can do without getting into the details about it to reduce the work on the database. And it did help a lot. Without select related, this page, which for those of you out there would be this page or this page. All the mod list details all share the same code. We have mod list detail, and it gets the mod list based on the slug, which is this guy up here. So without this select related, this page, even with caching on the live version, it was just unusably slow. It was like really horrifying. That came as a result of dividing the mod lists into sections, which was a feature requested by OneMac. Big thanks to OneMac if you're out there, and hope you're doing okay. As I was developing this, I was really excited about the cool possibility of having mod lists broken up, make it a little more readable. But I was horrified at the performance. It was really, really terrible, and I knew that I goofed. I knew that I kind of had reached the limits of designing a database as a dude that doesn't know jack about designing databases. So anyway, that's why I have to be really thoughtful about these kinds of changes. And for now, we're just going to do the really nasty, ugly thing here, which although it's really nasty and ugly, it's a lot less nasty than, you know, causing performance of the website to hurt in a way that it doesn't need to. So all that having been said, I need a sip of coffee. Now, we can finally type the what's next section. And, so I think to kind of expand upon what Hudrax mentioned, I think what's next for people may be, you know, you're interested in the community, you're interested in Morrowind and modding and OpenMW and all that stuff, come hang out, right? Come and join the Discord. Come and join the stream. Come and join the GitLab. Just come and hang out and let us know your ideas, your thoughts, and things that you want. I think that's a good takeaway. And keep it chill and friendly. Gotta mention IRC. You gotta keep it alive. There's gonna be a day when Discord goes south and everybody's gonna wanna jump shit. I'm calling it. You remember this day, I called it. I got nothing against Discord necessarily, but it's gonna happen. Because they are a business. So we're gonna keep the IRC there. And, just rehash the links we got here again. Oh! Too many quotes. I think this is where I'm going to mention the stream right here. Please also feel free to check the twice a week stream. This might be a run-on sentence. I don't know. Any grammar people, help me out here. English grammar was not a good subject for me. I was more interested in video games in those days, and it shows as an adult. Excuse me. There we work on improving and updating the website. I think it's pretty good. Let's reload the page. Let's see what it looks like. Whoa. Punching my mic. All right, from here, if you've got further interest in the community, come hang out in the project Discord or IRC and discuss all things related to this project, OpenMW, and Morrowind modding in general. Welcome back, Gonzo. Just got the what's next section, rough draft, typed out here. Please also feel free to check the twice a week stream the website creator does, where we work on improving and updating the website. And obviously the link needs to go in there. Let's see. Looks good. Thanks for the feedback. I appreciate it. That's awesome. Thank you, Smalio. All right. The twice a week. Let's give it a big old link here. I don't like this sentence at all, though. Ugh. Where's Sten when you need him? Twice a week. All right. First off, let's just look at it how it is. I don't know. Again, I'm very poor at grammar, but something about this sentence just really rubs me wrong. All right, hold on. First off, what's next? Excuse me. Oof. Gotta love those coffee burps. What's next? Okay, check the twice. That huge link. Feel free to check the Twitch stream, the website creator streams twice a week, etc. That's great. Thank you. Ah, words are hard. Thank you, Gonzo. That actually sounds natural. My coffee-addled face trying to convey something poorly. All right, let's... Please also feel free to check the project Twitch stream, the website creator streams twice a week and works on improving and updating the website. Whoa. Too much. The project Twitch stream. The needs to be in there. Check the project Twitch stream. Website creator streams twice a week. Works on improving and updating the website. I think that's okay. I give GitLab another mention. Good old link to GitLab. We want to make sure people, that gets extra call out too, because maybe, you know, I totally get it. Maybe somebody doesn't want to come into Discord. Maybe they don't want to come into IRC. Maybe they don't want to join the stream, but they do want to communicate with the project. I get a lot of emails from people that I only talk to over email. I get that. And so, you know, we want to invite them at least maybe to go into GitLab instead. All right. Whoop, wrong page. Okay. There's also the project issue tracker on GitLab. So I think this is pretty okay without being too overwhelming, right? We reiterate that we've got community on Discord where we're just chilling, talking about stuff. We link people to this very stream, which will also, I think, get them to my YouTube which has the stream archive. If people want to, you know, spend an entire day watching me slap a keyboard. And then there's the issue tracker. Let's make sure all these links are good. 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 Uh-oh. Didn't mean to do that. Good. Hudrak says, for us, it could be an obvious thing, but since most mod lists out there are a one-off, it might be worth mentioning at the end that your mod lists are supported and updated regularly. That's a really good point. That's another one of those things where it's hard, you know, it's hard to think about what other people might think. And that is, I think, something that I don't really think about, because obviously I know it's my website. I know when we update it. Somebody might not know, though, if they're just coming here. So might worth mentioning at the end. It's mentioning, I think, good opportunity to link the change logs. Also, boom, good idea, Gonzo. Yeah, because I was thinking, okay, so mention the website change logs, of course. And also kind of give a mention slash shout out to the mod community at large, right? Like, Morrowind mod community is extremely alive and active, and there's always new cool stuff, especially each May. You know, so we can mention something like that, and then not just imply, but also mention, yeah, that the website, in turn, gets updated a lot, too. And we are responsive to problem reports and things like that. So, yeah, okay, let's, you know, I'll just start typing something. I need a coffee. Hang on. All right. It's a drink your breakfast kind of a day for me today. All right. Okay. Hudrak says, I don't think I'd be exaggerating in saying that this project have the most supported and updated Morrowind mod lists on the web. And, you know, first off, wow, thank you. First off, thank you. You know, I appreciate you saying that. That means a lot. It's certainly what I'm going for. I'm not, like, trying to be the best, but I'm certainly trying to have good content, accurate content, and meaningful content, too. So I appreciate that. And yeah, you know, Morrowind is just, I don't know, like, it's my favorite game. I have, like, a, you know, interest in it that's beyond what a reasonable person should have. That's why I'm glad you folks are here with me. We all love Morrowind. So yeah, and so I'm trying to convey, how do you convey this in a sentence, right? Like, it's a super active community. We're a super active subset of the community. One of us, that's right, my friend. Our sugar is yours. So how do you convey that in a sentence without being, like, too wishy-washy? I don't know. So too is the community around this website. We remain focused on keeping the mod lists and content I think just describing who Drek says, I think just describing that you support and update the mod lists on your stream, maybe. Okay. Yeah, right, because I'm getting a little kind of, like, I'm honestly not sure if I love this sentence at all. Let's throw it down there for a minute. Would be, I think, so first off, that bottom sentence, history, And be sure to check the mod list and website change logs often. And happy modding. Which I just like to say that. Because we should. That's why we're here, right? To have fun. The mod list. Website. Whoa. Whoops, don't try auto-completing too much at home. Amen, Hudrax. Preach. All right. I'm glad you guys agree. Appreciate that. It's good to not be, like, in tunnel vision on this thing. It's what I love the most about doing the stream, I just want to say. Since 2017, I just did this website alone. And it started to get a little kind of, you know, it started to become a bit of a drag doing it alone. So it's really great to be here with all you guys today. And every day on Discord. What is the name? No, that's wrong. Santa says, you're a natural VTuber. Well, VTuber. I hope that's a typo. And thank you, my friend. You gotta come over and hang out soon, dude. All right. What is the name after the 29th? It's catastrophe. By the way, another one of my IRL friends says, I could listen to you read the phone book. If you say so, my dude. All right. What am I doing here? You guys are distracting me. The mod list change logs. Change log. Phone book stream. War, another IRL friend, hey man, says I could listen to you. Well, welcome, and I'm glad you're here. Come and listen to me speak about phone books and change logs. And linters. Ah, yeah. ASMR, no. War, if you might remember CESP from back in the days when we all played Minecraft, it's catastrophe. That's Mr. CESP. They know it. Two IRL friends that don't know each other, but they kind of do know each other, not IRL. It's cool when that happens. That's him. Hudrek says, yeah, I recently discovered Johnny is an awesome VA and narrator pro on the side. Well, I appreciate you saying that. I don't mind saying that in another life, I would have loved to be like a radio broadcasting person, but it just didn't work out. I did interview, and I think I mentioned this on a stream before, I interviewed at a radio broadcasting school in Chicago one time, and I got cold feet and backed out, and I decided to be a Linux person instead. Here I am. You never knew that? Yeah, it's actually when I was working with you, man, when I was at WiredTree. I was, like, so sick of working overnights, and I hated my shithead boss, and just wanted something better for my life. And I got there, at least. But yeah, true story. All right, I got off the deep end here. Let's see here, change logs. Gone way off the deep end here. Change logs, aptly named. Change logs, doing this from memory. Website, because I've done it twice now. Mod list. That's it. Website change logs. That's it. Awkwardly empty. We'll get there. We haven't even really looked at the diff yet today. Okay. So real quick, I think this is a mod. This website's mod lists and content receive regular updates, including each week. On the regular project stream. Is that a weird sentence? I don't know. Be sure to check the mod list and website change logs often. And happy modding. I don't know. I'm happy to leave it at that. Less is more. I don't want to say too much. I very easily say too much. Here's your ASMR, Santa. You want to hear me drink some coffee? Gonzo says, this website and its mod lists receive regular updates. Yeah, that's better. My friends who are not native English speakers are probably amazed by the fact that I'm a native English speaker, because sometimes I tell you. War says, today is 2-for-1 coffee at a local place for Father's Day, and they gave it to me for free anyways. Yeah, I mean, but you're technically a dad. Rudd's hard. Yes. Indeed. Oh, my God. And like I said, it's just one of those, I don't know, I kind of woke up on the wrong side of the bed. 2 pot of coffee kind of a day. And since I'm kind of like going off the deep end here, I did want to say, too, for those of you that are with me right now, what I want to get into, I'm burying the lead a little bit. We may even be doing this in like 10 minutes, but I want to mention and give a shout out to Lemoot of the OpenMW team, who's a regular contributor, and Nelson, who are regular contributors to the OpenMW-CS side of the project, which is, I think, the bastard stepchild of the project, really. Everybody loves OpenMW, obviously, but OpenMW-CS, I feel like, doesn't get enough love for how actually awesome it is. And I've had a really fantastic conversation the past day or so with Lemoot, because I'm, as I mentioned, I am, yeah, Gonzo says, oh, heck yes, I want to see an OpenMW-CS stream. It's coming, my friend. I'm building a mod, though, and a quest mod, a big one, too. And the quest mod, I want to build interiors. I want to have dungeons and stuff. And I want to build a world. And I want to use OpenMW-CS. Because if you don't know, the Morrowind CS that comes with Morrowind, it works. Barely. But it's so freaking painful. Like, alright, I'm going to go there. Just to show you. And I assume people on Windows have to go through similar bullshit. Pardon my language. Yeah, see, okay, so I have multiple monitors set up here. You can't see the CS. It's running. Hang on, let me just move it over here. Okay, so I've moved it over to the... Oh, wait, you can't see it yet? Because, yeah, we have all these other windows I gotta drag over here now. You know, I assume people on Windows have to go through this too, but I'm running it with Wine, so you could say, well, that's just Wine being derpy, you know? But then, to make it even worse, if I don't move it back to my main display on my laptop, and I remove my two displays and I run the CS again, it's gonna render them on the invisible non-existent display, so I have to make sure to like move it back over here if I want it to be usable later on, like when I'm on the couch or something, you know. I have to move it back over here, and it's so awkward. That's not even the most really awkward part about it. If you've used the CS, Gonzo knows what I'm talking about for sure. If you use the vanilla CS, you know, it's just like one of the most awkward pieces of software I think probably ever made, which is, I think, it's amazing, then, you take that fact as a fact, because it is a fact, it's amazing that not only the Morrowind developers created Morrowind with that, because that's basically what they used to create the game, but even still today, you have an army of modders that are creating amazing content with that piece of shit software, you know, which, you know, again, I love the CS, I love the creators of it, no disrespect, but it's trash. We can do better, and actually OpenMW-CS can basically replace the vanilla CS for almost everything. I think maybe even everything. My two complaints really were snapping, grid snapping, which the vanilla CS has, and resource snapping. Vertex snapping would be preferred, so you're snapping to like the actual parts of the polygons, you know. But resource snapping is still really cool, and the vanilla CS doesn't have that. The vanilla CS also doesn't have filtering. You know, even Abbott, who's a known amazing person in the community and also a huge critic of OpenMW, even Abbott on his website gives props to the OpenMW-CS features that we have. So, I mean, it deserves more attention. And yeah, I'm creating all my content, all the patches that I've made thus far, I'm creating with the CS. And in particular, on the 0.49 branch, the dev builds of the CS are just really awesome. And there's so many cool features. So, went on a super, you know, tangent here, but props to Lemoot, props to Nelson. And we have Lemoot and I have an ongoing discussion about some of the things we want to see in the CS, because right now, all right, we're going there. We're going off the deep end. Right now, when you're creating something in the CS, it can be really painful. For example, let's say I'm using, and you rightfully, if you're creating a mod today in 2023 or beyond, if you're not using OAAB data, What are you even doing with yourself? Okay, go out there, get it, add it into your CS, and come back. Okay, so let's test mod here. And all right, so cool. I got, you know, all the assets that Morrowind comes with. I got all the assets that OAAB data comes with, and we can check this out. We can say, okay, model animation, and we can say OAAB, and we can do it like this to see only stuff that's added by OAAB data. And this is a prop to all the people on that team, Melchior Dark, and everybody. I love you so much. 4,267 records. And yeah, that's how you do that. Well, so there's a couple ways. They, as a project, is one of the reasons why I respect them, because they care about being useful to content creators. You'll notice here on the left side there, it's all AB underscore something. So that's something you could key in, right? You could say ID starts with AB underscore. But you also note that the model paths all are in the OAAB folder. And I think that's a bit of a safer thing to key in on, right? Like maybe they've got some, if we just scroll way down here, maybe they do have some records. No, they in fact, all 100% of them, at least the ones that are in the OAAB directory, are prefixed with AB. I mean, so props, this right here is why I love the project. It's a great resource to use. But why am I showing you this? Because look at this. We have 4,267 records, but like, what the hell even is all this stuff? Yeah, okay, I can right click and hit preview, and then I can do this. And now I can kind of see like, oh, okay, this is a cliff. Awesome. But like, to go from here on the left side to here on the right side to where I'm actually seeing what it is, you know, it's a little bit cumbersome. And I feel like we need a way to like flip through things quickly. And so that's one of the things I'm talking about with Lewitt that you may very well see in a future iteration of the CS as we try to make it a more useful tool to actually build cool stuff with. My intention is someday I'm going to hit up Random Pal and just say, theoretically, Random Pal, I'm not trying to convince you to use OpenMW-CS, but let's just think if Random Pal was going to use the CS to make all of their content exclusively, what's missing? What's stopping them from doing that today? And we want to implement all those things, basically. And the goal is not to make Random Pal use the CS. Of course, that would be amazing. But the goal is to make it like a useful tool for anybody. For me, you know, I want to build a big dungeon. And I'll tell you right now, if I didn't have snapping and stuff, it would be a non-starter. But we do. So anyway, went way off the deep end there. Let's come back to the page, finish it up. Because we're over halfway done here. Oh, yikes. Gone way off the deep end here. So I'm going to bring all this stuff into the diff. We got a bit. Whoa, whoa, not that one, though. Whoops. Don't try that at home. Don't try staging things too quickly, folks. All right. Sip of coffee. I probably should give the coffee a rest, but we're just going to keep going. I will, though. Get a swig of water. All right. Now, where were we? We're wrapping up the redesign of the front page, which, if I do say so myself, I think is a smashing success. I think that what we have today, right here on this setup, is a vast improvement over this. I really do think it is. We go from this, potentially later today, to this. Pretty good. I think it's pretty good. And then the new folks can come here and hopefully they find the information as useful as, you know, Hudrax and others have found it. I think we're looking pretty good. Oh, excuse me. So one consequence of it being a two coffee pot day is that I'm going to need to go AFK right quick for just a second. But wait, hey, hold on. We're going to scan this real quick. And then I want to make sure we got everything committed. So what do we got here? Let's review all the code changes before I bathroom break real quick. We got the manager, the query manager that I made just to simplify accessing top level lists. We got plugging in the, okay, this is why we do this code review friends, okay? Someday, Gonzo is going to be a Python master, and he's going to be code reviewing my actual Python. But for now, he's just buddy checking the content in the MRs, which is super helpful. Yeah, thank you, Hudrax. I should just go do that now. Well, let's really quick look at this diff, though. It says, passes the potty break baton to Johnny. Yes, it's going to be, I got a pot of coffee, I got an unopened LaCroix here, and I got a glass of water. I'm trying to stay hydrated and also awake at the same time, which ends up in needing a potty break. So, okay, so objects, we're just defining the regular query manager, which is just provided by Django in this thing called manager. Top level list manager is the thing I wrote. Is plain list is what I wrote yesterday. We don't actually need this now, though. I'm going to go ahead and throw this away. It's not like it's anything revolutionary anyways. You know, I'm just simply doing this. But we're no longer... I wrote that for the long-winded way of doing what top-level list query manager gives us. We don't need this anymore. So for the sake of keeping the number of changes we're doing small and not bringing in some dead code, goodbye. Okay. So that's it for the models change. We're not going to add this, so let's unstage that. This would be all the user's guide changes that we've been talking about for roughly the past hour. We've reviewed that, I think, pretty thoroughly. There's no need to look at the raw HTML there. And this would be, for the last day, really, all of the this page, the index page. In website parlance, the index page is just the first page or whatever, slash, if you will. So modding openmw.com, or if your website was, you know, ilovefargoth.com, it would be ilovefargoth.com. Main nav, I did a bit of changing to this nav. I removed some stuff here. I don't want to remove the ability for people to send emails via the contact and feedback form, but I kind of want to move away from encouraging that, just because I have such a huge email backlog there, and I feel really terrible because people are reaching out to me to tell me something or ask for help, and like, it's over a year now. Some people have waited for a response. You know, I just became too much for me to get to in a timely manner. So I'm making those pages less prominent, but I haven't deleted them. I don't like deleting pages at all. But yeah, so I took them out of the nav thing here and made other changes. In the router, let's see here. We removed a comma to put it all on one line, because my auto formatter has weird opinions depending on if commas exist in certain places. An annoyance of the tool, but nonetheless, it's helpful. We went from a static view on the index page to a dynamic view that I wrote, which we'll get to in the next file. It's a change we want. The dynamic view exists so that we can know counts of things. Good, good. And the user's guide page, similarly, needs a little bit of data, which we pass in. So, cool. Looking good. And then we have our CSS changes, which only amounts to really two rules that we wrote. Not that bad. Awesome. I'm basically ready to commit this and call it done. The redesign of the homepage done. Actually, so what I'm going to do is, we're going to go ahead and deploy the beta site while I'm running to the restroom, and then we can all take a look at it, you know, on there and have a final say. So, all right, well, let's get that going. Good, good. All right. And so I will leave you folks for just a moment. Talk amongst yourselves, and I'll be right back. No topic. Whoops. Well, okay. Todd Howard, facial hair or no? Talk amongst yourselves. No, I'm just kidding. I'm going to have to come up with something. All right. Let's see here. What do we got? All right. So we're deploying this. All right. Yeah, that's right. I left it off. What we're looking at here, by the way, if you didn't know, is my code for putting in a nutshell. This takes my website code and puts it on the server so you can see it when you open your web browser. It's my deploy process, is what we call it in the business. And I'm using something called Ansible. And that's what all this output comes from this thing called Ansible. Eventually, I'm going to have all that be open source. I'm actually going to rewrite the deploy code because it's made for a very old version of Ansible that doesn't really work anymore. I tried to use the newest version of Ansible and it all blew up on me. That's a really great feeling. My code doesn't work and I changed nothing. Oops. Someday I'll do that in my copious free time. For now, I've got this moldy old deploy code that I'm using that takes a long time to. I'm sure it can be made to take a little bit less time if we thoughtfully design it. Let's... About done. Boom, there we go. Okay. Mm-hmm. All right. So I got a little bit of caching going on here, but we can see... yeah, too much caching. Okay, this is what we're going to do. Maybe we can... Oop. We can open a private browsing session. There we go. Man. Yeah. Looking good. Thank you, Gonzo. Yeah, I agree. I think this is a nice look. Subscribe. We'll take us to this page. The mailing list. Okay. We have to talk about this page, though. The mailing list, I basically never even once really posted anything to. And anyways, nobody uses it. In my perfect world, everybody would use the mailing list, but yeah, just not happening. So let's, this has to get changed too. And unfortunately, the mailing list is going to go. Bye-bye. I mean, the mailing list is going to stay there. I'm just not going to use it or promote it. So let's take a look here. What do we put there instead? IRC channel. Okay. And the project. Be a part of the community discussions. I think that's okay. Better than what it was. Certainly the mailing list would probably just puzzle people. Huh? What's a mailing list? It's a fair question. And I applaud Drew DeVault for really trying to make them a thing again. I really do. Issue tracker takes us to GitLab. Okay. That's not a link. Okay. This one. Okay. Discord. Right. There we go. IRC. I think it's, just for consistency. I'm not going to call it Libera Chat, even though that is the gracious host of my IRC channel. We're just going to say MONW on IRC. Whoa, my goodness. Fat fingers today. So fat fingers today. Okay, on IRC. I think that's better. Nah, too much. All right, I think that's okay. I think that's okay. Let's go look at the diff again. Excuse me. Good. We want that. Just did that. We definitely want that. Added a word. I think that's a wrap. I think I'm about to sneeze. Oof. Coffee will help. All right. Yeah, I guess no sense overthinking it. Let's put a bow on it, huh? I think that's a fair summary of these changes without getting into the, you know, the nuts and bolts of every what every line does, you know. That's just a good succinct summary. Okay, now, first question I have is, what did I break? What did I break? Let's get this going. And head back to our list here. Okay. We can put an X on that one. I jumped around and, well, I have been devoting the ending of the stream lately to looking at the CS. We could take a look at grid and resource snapping, if that seemed like something you folks wanted to look at. We could maybe make a BS interior and throw some stuff around. Or we can look at the issues backlog. Actually, there was an issue that was filed shortly before the stream that I didn't notice that I actually want to get everybody. Okay, this is what we're going to do. I want to get everybody's feedback about this. But we also have the changelog detail page, which I've added the point here to have an all changes ever page since Hudrax mentioned, you know, that's something they'd like to see. So certainly we can provide. It would be like this maybe. Lists, list, name, change, log, all, something like that. Not doing that today, though. Not enough time, but we will do it soon. I've already deployed the beta website. I'm going to check it off just for the sake of checking it off. But you'll know, yeah, we had a pretty good pretty good percentage of completion here the past couple of times. Let's take a look at the issue backlog. And yeah, this one just came in, which is actually really good timing because I was browsing Nexus mods somewhat recently and I noted that Random Pal has one of those miscellaneous mods pages and they had a Caldera Mine expanded. Yeah, this one. This one, okay. Yeah, awesome. I love this. Props, Ronic CZ. Thank you. They have contributed a few issues to the project, pointing things out. So yeah, thank you for doing this. Props. So, about a week ago, I noticed this thing existed. Oh, yeah, well, but I noticed it on a random mods page. Looks like it has its own page here now. Ah, Hudrex, thank you for mentioning that. And Hudrex says, speaking of Random Pal, BCOM now has a global that can be used to check if BCOM is installed so that NPCs can be moved to a different position with a simple script. Hype. Yeah, actually, I noticed that change as well, and I took the liberty of trying to apply that to my Oh No Stolen Reports mod. Because you may know that that mod has a BCOM enhanced version that's a separate plugin But actually, thanks to that global that RandomPal put in new versions of BCOM, we're now able to have just one plugin that supports BCOM and without. And how I do it is in the script where I decide what reports you're going to get. I do this right here. I say, if BCOM active is 1, give me 16. Otherwise, give me 8. And with just that simple check, I can now support BCOM without having to really think about it. You could argue it's a little spicy because the BCOM version had previously listed BCOM as a master and its dependencies as masters. We no longer get that. I think it's fine. As is, the dev builds here work. I tested it out. It works. It's beautiful. There is a problem with the place. There is a place. So the original 8 random locations for each scroll for vanilla, the 8th one is different between the BCOM version and the vanilla version, and I need to make a kind of a version agnostic location, new location. Other than that, though, this is like ready to go, and I'm ready to do the 2.0 update of this mod to leverage that feature that you just brought up. So yeah, good call out, Hudrex. Props to RandomPal and Melchior Dark and all those guys, you know, just awesome, awesome. And yeah, I was excited. If you couldn't tell, I was excited to like use that global and see like how could I simplify my mod. And yeah, there it is right there. To BCOM or not to BCOM? It's a simple question. Anyways, I noted this one and had actually added this to my setup because there's problems with the Caldera Mine expanded mod. And what this one does is just takes away all the quests, dialogues, everything, and just gives you the neat scenery. And I was preparing to actually remove the full version of the mod from mod lists for this one. You can see I'm tracking it here even. But if this one has been updated and I simply am not tracking it, yep. Indeed. Very recently it was updated. How about that? So I'm thinking, rather than gut the mod, original authors replied to that. Thank you, Hudrex. Okay. Excellent. That's excellent. I'm not really sure. In the main page description. Oh, of this one? Okay, thank you, Adrex. Of the old other mod, okay. Am I missing something here? I digress. Taking a step back, I have to make the decision. Do we want to keep the full version of the mod? No, thank you. There we go. Right, it's right here in front of me. Thank you, Hudrex. I appreciate that. There's recently been a mod that has released that claims that CME is very buggy. This is incorrect. But we have updated CME to account for any smaller errors that do exist. I'm not going to lie. When I read the description here, it said something about explosions and stuff, constantly exploding Caldera Mine. I had never actually ever seen that, and I was a little surprised to read that. They will never solve compatibility issues. So, you know, that's something I'm happy to address if there's compatibility, but I don't know if there's major compatibility issues with this one and Total Overhaul as is. I'm actually not sure. It's been a while since I played through this one, even. Definitely have not played through it since I added BCOM into the mix. So I don't know. Are there compatibility-related problems that we have with this? I'm not 100% sure. Nobody's reported anything, aside from not being able to find one cave that they move. Not a bug. So yeah, I'm left wondering, Do we want to stick with the original? And I'm inclined to say, yeah, you know, we should. Who Drax? I've tested it on your TO setup. So far, no issues. All you're missing to test is Halalu and Redoran quests. Gotcha. Okay, that's good feedback. I'm inclined to think that if the Telvanni quest at least isn't busted, you know, there's hope at least that the other two aren't. So, okay, I'm thinking I'm going to revert my local setup to have the original mod again. Respects to the Caldera Mine expanded team. And, you know, if there are compatibility issues that my mod lists introduce, we'll handle them. We'll just make a patch. All right, so yeah, we're going to keep this one. And again, thank you to RonicCZ. And I'm going to go ahead and after the stream, I'm going to respond here. And we'll basically outline what I'm talking about here. We're going to keep the original version of the mod and update. I think that this is a 5.x change, to be clear. We're going to update the mod lists. No longer recommend the fix plugin that I link to people. We're just going to say just the base mod now is all you need. And I think that counts as a point fix that we can include, you know, for the 5.x release. So that's a good one. Good call out there. Oh yeah, I saw these come in. And this is a good one from Gonzo. I believe we talked about this on Discord. Definitely want to include that. Probably in 5.6, honestly. This is a really good request. Morrowind Advanced. I've never actually heard of this before, but Lone Wolf says was started by a Morrowind dev. Let's take a look. Since we've been recently treated with content from devs, this piques my interest. And you can see right now, this is actually really old content. This is really old. Gary Noonan. And I did scroll through this a little bit when I saw the email come in about this issue. And it seems interesting. I question, just looking at some of this stuff, I question how much it actually fits. It seems like how much it fits with Morrowind. It seems like it's influenced by maybe Daggerfall stuff. Worth looking at for sure. This is one of those ones that I wouldn't just throw into a mod list, you know, because it has so much content here. Because of that, and also because obviously of compatibility concerns, you know, you'd want to really make sure it fits well. But this one is worth a look. And I never knew about it. And it's old. Really old. So, very, very cool call out here, Lone Wolf. Thank you for that. And another one. Pirate Lord's Creatures X1. I've heard of this one. I know I have. This is another one, though, that borders on the bizarre, if I remember correctly, just in terms of what it adds. But also a lot of really cool stuff, right? I don't know. This one actually looks pretty interesting. See, so like this one, the Landro. Excuse me, that one's added by OAAB data, so there's a little bit of overlap here. Cool fishies. Sky creatures. Bee. That's pretty awesome. I love it for the bee alone. Tomb of the Snow Prince adds some of these kinds of critters. Definitely. The ice worm thing is interesting. Hudrek says, food for thought for the future. So many issues on Total Overhaul can be solved with minimal use of the console. I mention this because we can think about compiling console solutions for the site when actual patching is either too much of a hassle or not possible. It's a shame to remove some mods when they can be made to function with light consoling. So that's a great call out. Thank you, Hudrek. That's a great call out. And I just want to say, In virtually every case where consoling will solve a problem, a patch can be made. Because a patch oftentimes simply boils down to automating what you do in the console. At a low level, that's really all you're doing. So it's reassuring to know that you solved things with AFresh with simple console tweaks, because fundamentally a patch is just going to boil down to doing that. There's some implementation details we would think about, but yeah, I believe that AFFA is working on an update to that one, and I was waiting for that one to drop before I started chipping away at patches. Also, I haven't finished all the quests just yet. I have a playthrough I'm doing on my Steam Deck. I really wish I could show. Yeah, not. I see. Good to know. Hudrek says, yeah, definitely. Anything you're consoling, because in the, you know, let's go back here to my, you know, whoop, no, that's not star. That's not in a file that exists anymore. In the, you know, in a script that you attach to something, if you're disabling a wall in the console to fix something, you would simply do, you know, that wall. And there's your patch. Now, if it's something that doesn't have, like, a unique ID, you'd simply give it a unique ID, you know? And you know, there's, like, some rules to doing patching right. But, yeah, I mean, you know, there's your console right there in a mod, in a patch. So, you know, when you click on something and type disabled, this is the mod patch code version of that. There really isn't a lot to it. And I can't think of any scenario where you would do that in the game and we wouldn't be able to make a patch for it, honestly. I can't really think of any, so. If you can console it, we can patch it. All right. So, yeah, great call out. That's a very great call out. I hope to very soon. You know, from my perspective, Hello Fargoth and AFresh are going on the iHeart Vanilla list. You know, they're unofficial expansions. And we definitely want them on all the lists. I've seen, for example, in the Samaris Ancestral Tomb, you know, there's an item placed in there. And a few other things that we'll have to change, but not much, I don't think. So far, I haven't really seen really anything, but I haven't seen everything yet. So, back to the list, because I've kind of, like, lost track of what we're doing here. All right. Oh, we're looking at GitLab issues. Okay. So we're kind of at an impasse here. And I think I want to fire up the CS. We looked a little bit at that. And I think I want to fire up the CS. And I want to look at snapping, because I don't know what folks that work on TR, what folks that work on Province Cyrodiil, what Random Pal thinks they need from the OpenMW-CS. But I've tried to create content with it a few times, and I know what I would need. And grid snapping is something, though, that I remember people hearing from people that they need in order to use it. So, I mean, let's just take a quick look at how we would do that, shall we? Let's just make a silly little interior and snap some stuff around and see if it's usable. Yeah, I can't promise that we're going to make anything cool or that it won't be hideous. My example thing. All right. So, I'm going to go ahead and just right-click here to add a record. And we're going to, down here, that pops up this thing here, and we're going to add an interior cell. My test cell. And we're going to edit the record over here. Oh, hello there. Just demonstrating. We're going to say it's interior sky. No region. It is an interior. Then. And, okay. Control S to save it. Now, how do we put stuff in it? Right click, view. And at this point, we're basically done with this cells pane. So I'm going to close that. But we need to know about stuff. And like I did before, I want to play around specifically with OAAB data stuff. So let's filter that down, shall we? Model animation. OAAB. Very good. All right. But wait, I need to filter down a little bit more. So let's do some of this filter chaining that everybody hates that I actually love. I can understand why people hate it, but it's actually really, once you get the gist of it, it's super powerful. Okay, so let's say I want an ID that's like floor. Cool, we got 42 records. Cool, okay. Floor, ship, floor large. Maybe that's like a shipwreck something, so we just drag and drop. Cool, all right. We got something. For our purposes, this is good. So let's middle click it to select it. To use the grid snap then, after you select it, you hold control, you right click on the blue arrow to move it up and down, for example. And look, grid snapping. You can see it grid snapping there. Gonzo says, damn, that is a good looking mesh. I know, right? Just, wow, like, all of these. You know, let's just, let's drop another one down. Cave mold floor 01. I mean, just look at this. Awesome. Like, this is some good stuff. I'm like, this is why in my mod making, I'm not done, like, writing the dialogue and stuff, but this is why I want to jump into, like, making the dungeon, because, like, there's so much cool stuff here, you know? Like, let's build a world, right? All right, so let's select this. Hold control, right-click. Look, Mom, snapping. Snapping. I'm snapping like the creeper, you know? I'm creeping, I'm snapping. Ah, pretty good, huh? Just like that, we're snapping. Now, there is the reference snapping feature, too. I can hold shift and right-click something else, or middle-click something else, highlighted in yellow. And this activates reference snapping, which is only available in 0.49 builds of the CS, by the way. This is actually as far as my understanding of the feature goes, though, because I couldn't actually get it to work. But let's try to hold control, right-click. And I think maybe it is working and I just don't know what it's doing, but I think it is snapping relative to the position of this thing. So I can like move it around, whatever, free move it, and then now hold control and I'm snapping to something on this. Let's go down a little bit and see. Hold control and boom. Yeah, I'm snapping here. Boom. We are, yeah, look at that. It's level with this thing. Pretty good, I think. So, I mean, if anybody asks, can OpenMW-CS do snapping? You got it right here. It can do two kinds of snapping. It can do what the vanilla CS does, which is just this thing. Click, select it with middle click, hold control, right click, and we got grid snapping, which is configurable, by the way, if you go into preferences here, it's in here somewhere. Yeah, here we go, scale snap size, angle snap size, grid snap size, it's all configurable. You can say how much you want to snap. I don't know if that's configurable in the vanilla CS. Maybe it is. If so, good. If not, ha, take that, Todd. I love you. So yeah, I mean, there you have it. We're building worlds with OpenMW-CS. We're using the grid snap feature. We're using the relative reference snap feature here, where we snap things relative to the position of other references. We get them like really perfectly lined up here. Just look at that. Boom. Pretty cool. I will say, I have been a critic of OpenMW-CS in the past. I've been a doubter of its abilities. Doubt no more. I mean, you can do some really awesome stuff. Just the only thing I really wish now is, you know, we need some icing on the cake. We need a cherry on top of the icing. You know, we need a good way to preview all these awesome resources that the phenomenal community has given to us with OAAB data. I mean, look at, slim down my query over here a little bit, which you can't actually see. I just realized my face is blocking the record filter here. Ooh, that's awkward. There it is. There we go. Now you can see it. Boom. That's better. I mean, just look at all this, though. 4,206. We need to do justice to this content. And we can do it with OpenMW-CS. One idea I had was, that I'm going to tell you right now isn't going to work. But one idea I had was, give us a column. You see these columns in the spreadsheet over here? Give us a column that is a preview box of the thing. Awesome, right? Except for, oh, now you're loading 4,000 models all at once. You know, going to make somebody's computer melt that way. It's not going to work. But that's why I had kind of like the catalog idea where we can like quickly scan left or right through things, you know. But that would really help this world building effort a lot, because as I'm looking through all this content, like I don't really know what... Some of it's obvious, right? Like I can go up here and I can sort it by record type. I can say like, okay, give me statics. Static. Just give me only statics. And then it's like, okay, well, yeah, palisade pole. I can guess what that is, but like until I plop it in here, I'm not going to know what the hell that is. And then I kind of, yeah, look at this. Oh, and this reminds me. While I'm in here talking about OpenMW-CS features that people wish it had or maybe don't know it has or maybe say it doesn't have, here's another one. Let's say I'm going to place this thing, and I know I'm going to place it. And I'm going to actually, like, let's snap it relative to this thing so we can get a nice tight snap there. Well, wait, no, I'm not going to do that. I'm going to float it above, but now I want to drop it. Select it. And you hit the H key to plop it down. And the H key specifically, if we look in the preferences here, it is specifically, come on, there we go, no. Where is it? Here we go. No, that's not it either. Somewhere in here, the H key is defined and we can look exactly what it's doing. But you have two different kinds of drops. So the the Morrowind CS gives you the F key, which will plop something on the ground, very similar to that. The OpenMW-CS has actually two forms of that. And if I wasn't derping right now, I could actually find the definitions of it. Oh, no. Ah, here we go. Scene. There we go. You have drop to terrain level, which is what I was hitting at first. I was hitting G. There's no terrain here. But if we were in an outside cell, that's how you would like plop something on the ground or whatever. You would just hit G. In this case, we need drop to collision. And we also have drop to terrain level separately, drop to collision separately, which I'm not entirely sure what those do. But there's something. It's there for us to use. So anyway, you know, just hit it. Float your thing up. Hit the H key. And you got a nice tight placement here. Okay, you're ready to build a world. And I can't help also but just think back to what Gonzo said. That is a good, this is a great looking mesh. It really is. Let's just, short wind med. Let's just plop some more stuff in here and see what we got here. Oh, okay. I was playing around with this one yesterday. This is like a wall of some kind. Right, like a, you can almost like build a swimming pool edge with this one. It's giving me swimming pool vibes. Oh no, there's a hole in here? That seems almost not right. Oh, hold up. Well, one of the things we can do here is we can change the lighting on the scene. Let's disable all shadowing. Yeah, there is a hole in it. How about that? How about that? Cool. Pretty cool. OpenMW-CS, my friends. You want to build a world? You want to make a simple patch? It can be done. It's very, once you get the gist of it, it's pretty easy, you know, and there's just a couple thing, key things you need to know about to really have success with using this thing. Plopping stuff on the ground, selecting with middle click, plopping it on the ground with H, snapping, Hammerfell style window vibes from that hole. You know, I'm not really too familiar with what you're referencing, but all right. Gonzo says, thanks for the demonstration. You're most welcome. And I really hope that you give it a try yourself. You know, open up the OpenMW-CS, make a bullshit cell, and just start throwing stuff down and play around with it. You know, you can actually, like, I don't know, like, we have the makings of something here. I don't know what it is, but it's something. And I just was literally plopping crap around. So, you know, you can do the same. It's not that hard. And I encourage you to do it and hook it up to an LLM. Farmer, you got your brain on large language models. Honestly, though, it would be pretty interesting, right? Like, have ChatGPT make you a level. We know that ChatGPT can't do guitar tabs, though. So I'm wondering how it would struggle with level design. All right. Wow. This is a really great stream. Yeah, I know. Sad face. Hey, I mean, maybe like ChatGPT 4, GPT 4, version 4 will be better at guitar tabs. I didn't ever check the chords it gave me for a Collective Soul song called Boast. I didn't ever check the chords, but I don't know. They seemed right. But the lead was just nonsense. Complete nonsense. All right. Well, hey, wait a minute. I know what we can do. We can end the stream by looking at my... Wouldn't you like to see this in-game? Because I sure would. All right, let's do it. Let's add it in-game. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do. All right. And so my example... Oh, wow, dot project. That's a new thing. I'm going to have to ask Lewitt about that. I have no idea what the hell that is. For now, we're just turning it on. My example thing. You ready to make my high-end potato melt? We're doing this. Run. Let's spawn right in there, shall we? All right. I was testing some stuff yesterday. We want TCL. We want super speed. Yeah, we want super speed. Okay, we do. What did I name this stupid cell here? My test cell. Is that one word? We're going to find out. My test cell. Okay, that's not the name. Maybe I put a space in there. My test cell. Do you have your startup script shared anywhere? Gonzo asks. As a matter of fact, no, I don't. That's a great question. And I absolutely want to share my startup script. I want to share my little, you know, this run.sh script. Like, I actually want to make this into something that is usable to people, you know. Give it an optional GUI, you know. And it could maybe have support for, like, you know, a better support for... Because OpenMW Launcher, you know, supports having your test script, but you kind of... Yeah, the console command script. Yeah, totally. No, but... I knew what you meant. I was just going off the deep end with talking about everything. But no, I don't have this shared anywhere. I was actually contemplating, so like for my patches collection, I was contemplating having like another text file in there that says, you know, if you want to test this patch, this is the console kind of that you need. So for example, Kogaroon, Extinct City of Ash and Sulfur, the Rise of House Tovani patch I made. I mean, this is how you test it. And Hudrax, going back to what I told you before, like I said, it's literally scripting a bunch of disables. That's your patch right there. And this is how you would test that mod. So, I don't know if my script in general would be useful to people, but maybe including like how to test this patch would for individual patches would be useful information. Okay. So, let's see. What am I doing here? User settings, close this. What is the name of my cell? God dang it. Sorted by added here. Let's be lazy. It's Oh Hello There is the name. Okay. Oh Hello There. Oh Hello There. And we'll end this stream by just checking out the little for funsies cell that I made. And you too can make a cell. Look at that. Hey, here we are. This is it, friends. It's that easy. And so we got a fake exterior. We're not really outside, but it looks like we're outside. As I recall, yeah, there's no god rays in fake quasi exteriors. They're called to the engine. You don't get any god rays. I don't even have that shader loaded at the moment, but I don't believe it works on a quasi exteriors. But yeah, this is it. Set game hour to 22. This is it, my friends. You too can make a simple exterior, make a dungeon, make a player home. Actually, the very first foray into CS hacking I ever did was I watched a video by Dark Elf Guy. Basics of how to make the CS, and I made just my own kind of, you know, BS player home by Sarah's Ancestral Tomb, southwest corner of the map. Some garbage Dwemer. I was just learning how to do stuff, but it was a lot of fun, and I encourage you to do the same. You know, make a player home. Make your, just to plop a hatch somewhere that loads to a cell, you know. It's a cool learning experience. It's a lot of fun. And if you do that and you got questions, you can definitely hop into the Discord channel and talk to us about it. Lately, I've got mod building on the brain. I don't know. So, okay, well, I guess that's it for today. It's been a great stream. I think we got a lot done. And to reiterate, this rethinking the main index page is a huge change. Going to open up the... We have actually MR opened already. And we did. Yeah, I got distracted. We didn't really get to all these other things. But I am going to include this in our open merge request here. We got for 5.6. I'll be working to close that out probably by the end of the day, and we'll deploy these changes to the website. And so I want to thank you for joining me, everybody. We had a great stream, and everybody out in YouTube Lab watching after the fact, and happy modding, and I hope to see you all next time. Have a great, lovely day. Take care, and I'll see you later. Peace.